Hey everyone, today I'm going to be talking about our mortgage payoff. We have a new mortgage now, our loan has been sold, and we are going to go over the details of what we're paying and how we're paying it off a tiny bit faster. Mortgage payoff is something that is not necessarily the best financial move, especially if you can make more in the stock market, which with our low interest rate, of course we can. So we're investing a ton, and this mortgage payoff is really just a kind of luxury item that we are using some extra money to pay for. So whenever you're thinking about mortgage payoff, you have to think of whether or not it's actually worth it or not, because you're technically probably just buying a luxury for yourself, not making the best financial move based on the numbers. But that said, I am paying off our mortgage a little bit faster, and I am going to be doing updates about it every single month, because now that we have a 15-year mortgage, it is going a lot faster than the 30-year. So I will be sharing the numbers every single month, and this is the first mortgage payoff update of our new loan.
This is the first update in our new mortgage payoff series, where I'm starting with our new loan that was at $142,000. As you can see, I have my old amortization schedule, which was when we first bought our home, and the loan from when I first bought our house was $153,596. That was a 30-year loan, and then in 2020, we refinanced for a $142,000 loan. So I will be doing a mortgage payoff series, and I will be updating every single month because we are now paying off much more principal than we were before, so the movement is going to be a lot faster. This is just something I want to do personally, so it will be a monthly update on the channel from here on out. This is the monthly update for July 2020. We refinanced in April of 2020, so this is the first time that I am doing a update. We have made two payments on our loan so far. The first one was when we paid our June payment. And as a comparison, I just wanted to look at my old amortization schedule and see where I would have been if I was still paying on that loan and how far down the chart I would have been. It's really exciting to see how much faster this new loan is going to help us pay off the mortgage. Our loan was sold the month after we bought it, but I do not have the new amortization schedule, and I decided that I wanted to just work off of the one I had because nothing about our loan actually changed. It's still all of the same exact numbers, and nothing with the new service provider is going to change that. So it really doesn't matter which schedule I'm using to track my payoff. So therefore, I'm going to use the one that I've already started on and already have one payment crossed off, since that is the plan, just to cross them all off and then move ourselves forward on this schedule so that we're getting a little bit closer to paying off our mortgage every single time. Paying off our mortgage is something that we are not doing aggressively right now, but it is something that we want to accomplish because it is a personal goal, and for security purposes for myself, I really want a paid off home, because even if it has an interest rate, having a payment means that there could be a foreclosure if things go awry. So that's just a little bit of the personal reasons why we want to pay off our mortgage. So let's talk about the actual numbers. This is the July 2020 update for our mortgage payoff, but since it is the first mortgage payoff update that I've done in a while, and it is the first one that I'm doing with this new loan, I want to go over everything that we've done so far with our new loan since we refinanced in the month of April. So we refinanced in April, a couple days after my birthday actually, which was pretty fun, and then we have refinanced the loan at $142,000. Our home value right now is around $190,000 or $200,000. And our original purchase price was $158,000. So our payment with this first new loan, we paid $1,292.96. That is our actual payment that we owe every single month. Because we refinanced in the end of April, we did not have a May payment, so that was our June payment. And then our mortgage was sold when it was at the amount of $141,361.77. So that is the new mortgage with our new service provider from our refinance loan, and that is the amount that we are now going to be working on paying off every single month on this channel. So this is the payoff number one update, and I can't wait for more. So on the 23rd of the month, I decided to go ahead and pay our half payment that we had set aside in savings so that we could get set up on biweekly payments, and our payments would come out ahead of time before the amount we owed was due. That way it would be applied to the loan. If you do a half payment, it is not applied with most service providers, so it just kind of sits there and waits until your second half payment, and then it's applied. So even though it's not always being applied to the loan, because you're making biweekly payments, you're actually making 13 full payments throughout the year. So this pays off your mortgage faster. We are also doing a little bit of extra principal every single month to even out the number that we're paying. So we actually only owe $642.96 if we're doing half payments. But because we are trying to speed up the mortgage payoff in whatever ways we can, we just round that up to $650. So every time we make this payment every 2 weeks, we are going to put an extra $7.04 toward the principal balance of our loan. That's not a lot. It doesn't seem like a lot, but when you multiply that by every payment that we're making, it does add up and will contribute to paying off the mortgage faster. So on the 26th, we did make a full payment, which for us was going to be $1,300 because our payment is $1,292.96, but we do add that $7.04 to round it up and make sure that's applied to the principal. So breaking down our payment, the amount of $1,300, we end up only sending $639 to the actual principal balance from what we are paying, and then of course we do the extra $7.04. So in total, we are sending a little bit over $640 to the balance of the loan to reduce it every single time we're making payments. That's pretty exciting for me. That's way more. It's fully double what we were paying every single month to pay down principal before we transferred and refinanced to this new loan. That leaves us with a current mortgage balance of $140,707.99. That is pretty exciting. We are about to get back under the $140,000 mark, which we were at before we refinanced the loan, obviously, but since we rolled all of our closing costs into the loan, we are back up above $140,000, and that means the loan payoff has taken a couple steps back in order to take a few great leaps forward, because with this new loan, we are obviously paying off so much faster. It will break even pretty quickly, and without PMI, which we were paying before, it's even faster. It's pretty amazing, actually. So now I'm crossing off the second row of the amortization schedule because we have now made enough payments to move us two lines forward. Technically, we're a couple dollars under this $140,722, so we just barely made it, but I'm pretty excited that every single time that we're making payments, we are making progress. Okay, let's look at the new payment and how it breaks down. It is something that I wanted to show you guys just because I have shared the previous mortgage payment that we had and how much was going toward interest and PMI and how little of it was actually going toward paying the principal down. So I want you to see with our new loan, our new refinance loan that's conventional, how much exactly is being paid every time we make a payment. Of course, our starting balance for this loan was $142,000, and then our current balance as of this payment is $140,707.99. Since we have started paying on this loan, we have paid over $3,000. We've paid $3,242.60. So that's how much we've actually paid money out of our bank account, and the amount of the loan being reduced was just $1,292.01. If you're a big fan of debt payoff and mortgage payoff like I am, then you know that that doesn't feel great that you have sent so much money to other things like interest and even escrow, but you do see that we have paid off at least over $1,000, which is way better than our old mortgage payment was going. Our old loan was not that great, so we were not paying very much toward principal at all. So every time we are making a payment, we are sending $1,300 to our loan. That $1,300 breaks down as $639.70 toward principal, which is over double what our old payment was sending toward the principal reduction. And then we have $323.94 that goes toward interest. We don't have PMI on this new loan, but we do have $329.32 that goes toward escrow, which is to pay for our property taxes and, of course, our home insurance. Then because we round up to $1,300, we are paying $7.04 in extra principal reduction every time we make a payment. If I combine the regular principal reduction from our payment with the extra principal that we pay just by rounding up to $1,300 payment a month, we are then paying $646.74 to reducing the actual balance of this loan, which is pretty exciting. $646 toward principal reduction is way more than we were paying before, and it is going to get us so much closer to paying off this loan within a reasonable time frame, even faster than 15 years. I'll be honest, this is probably not our forever home, so we will likely, instead of paying this fully off, start saving for a new home that's in a more expensive price range. But because I do want to keep paying it off anyway, just in case our situation changes or we want to keep it as a rental, I am going to make a mortgage payoff chart and start at the $42,000 range where we started our new loan. That means each icon on this mortgage payoff chart is $1,420. This chart is available in my shop, so I will link it below. And just to start off, I decided to color in most of a house since we have actually reduced it by $1,200. That means we're not quite at the $1,420 mark, but we did make a big chunk of a reduction. So the first little house gets to be colored in, and then we will leave the door and the roof and all of that for when we do finally make it to $1,420 actually reduced.
So that's it for me today. I hope you join me on future mortgage payoff updates and check out my videos about how to pay off your mortgage faster. They are pretty useful if you're not trying to be super aggressive, but you still eventually want to pay it off home.